today. Oh, it's so good to see you. It's Miss G. And we're in the Seedlings Nursery. A little bit's changed since you were here last. We decorated a little different, and we've got things prepared for our new series under the Planted Children's Ministry called Superheroes. You want to come and join me? Okay, well, this week for week one, we're doing an introduction, which means Miss G's going to kind of cover what we're going to be doing for the next month or two. Okay, so what I've got down here, and we'll put one up each week, we'll have different ones on the walls. These are different Bible superheroes, and we'll be talking about several of them. Here's our little Bible hero series. We've been reading from some of those over the last couple months, lots of them. And so what we're going to do today, like I said, is do an introduction. And I thought, you know, Samuel's not on our list of Bible heroes, but this is a pretty neat lesson about being ready to listen and hear from God. Okay? So that when you go through this series, the next several weeks, you'll be able to get your ears out. You'll say, "I'm listening, God. What do you want to teach me?" Okay, here we go. Little Bible heroes. Samuel, he's just a little boy. Hannah, that's Hannah. She prays for a baby. Some of you are babies, but you're growing up into toddlers and getting big. God answers her prayers. She prays for a baby, and God answers her and gives her a baby boy named Samuel. Oh, I like that name, Samuel. When Samuel is old enough, he goes to live in God's temple. Do you know what God's temple is? It's kind of like our church. So he went to the church to live. Samuel helps the high priest, Eli. And Samuel wears a special linen vest that the priests wear. See, he's got a vest on. And he's helping with the chores. He's helping to keep God's house clean. He is a good boy, and he works very, very hard. Well, one night when Samuel is sleeping, he hears someone call his name. Samuel, he runs to Eli, and he says, "Here I am. You called me?" Samuel says. Well, Eli was asleep and he says, "Ooh," he yawns and he shakes his head. "No, I didn't call you. Go back to bed." It was nighttime. It wasn't time to be up. So Samuel hears someone call his name again. He runs to Eli, but the priest sends him back to bed. I think the priest Eli was getting a little upset, like, "It's time to sleep. Go back to bed." And then Samuel hears someone call him a third time. One, two, three. So he runs and wakes up Eli once more. "Here I am. You called me?" Samuel says. Eli knows that God, he is calling Samuel. And so he tells Samuel, "If you are called again, say, 'Speak, Lord, your servant is listening.'" So God calls Samuel again, and Samuel says, "Speak, Lord, your servant is listening." God answers, and this time Samuel listens and he hears an important message from God. So he opened his ears. He said, "Yes, speak, Lord. Your servant is listening. I'm ready." So when he grows up, Samuel becomes a great prophet and leader, and he still listens to God. So God used this little boy in his house to hear from him and do what he's called him to do. Do you know that God's got something for you to do as well? He has a calling on each one of your lives. He does. And I'm excited to see that play out so we can see what God has for you. In the beginning here, this is for a little parent connection point. It is about, thinking about a few things. So, what do you think it was like for little Samuel to grow up in the temple, to grow up in the church? Well, that would be kind of unique, kind of fun. God speaks to all of us in many ways. Well, what are some ways that God speaks to you? If you listen, he can speak to you through the Bible, through his word. He can speak to you through music when we're singing and praising him. He can speak to you when you're playing with your toys. Maybe he'll show you something and you'll know that's from God. In 1 Samuel 3:10, the Lord came, stood there, and called as before, "Samuel, Samuel." Samuel responded, "Speak, for your servant is listening." Again, from 1 Samuel 3:10. That's in your Bible. It's important to remember the one who is from God listens to God's words, John 8:47. So we want to stay ready to hear from God through his word, through the Bible. And so that is our little Bible heroes story on Samuel. So that is our introduction for the week, for the summer, for our superheroes lessons that will be coming out. So be ready to listen, okay, and learn about our Bible superheroes. It's going to be exciting summer. Okay, and as we always do in the month of June here in the Seedlings Nursery, we do superheroes and we talk about, well, it's going to be Father's Day coming up, and our daddies, they're our superheroes as well. So we'll be celebrating them this month, okay? So I hope you have a great week. I have been in prayer for each one of you. I'm excited because I got to see many of you this week. God just really opened some doors and allowed us to just run into you at different places. And that was exciting. I just love seeing you. So I hope you have a good week and we'll see you next week, okay? Miss G loves you. Take care. Bye-bye.